We play and call it work.
MiniWarGaming's Warhammer 40K Combat Patrol Battle Report.
Hey everybody, Matthew here from MiniWarGaming.com, and welcome to this pairing of Combat Patrol Warhammer 40K. Normally on Fridays we bring you incursion games, which are 1,000 points, but today we got something special. And no, we're not just doing 500 points because we don't feel like doing 1,000 points. It's because we actually want to try out playing these combat patrols on the new WarCry battle mats that Games Workshop came out with, which are all designed to be underground. And so what we've done is we've taken two of those WarCry battle mats, you put them together, and voila, you've got a combat patrol or incursion size, minimum size table. It's almost like Games Workshop planned that the kill team and WarCry battle mats match up with those minimum sizes for the tables. And because it's all claustrophobic with walls and doorways, we didn't want to try to put 1,000 points on each side on that, even though it's technically the same size mat as an incursion size game. So we thought this would be a lot more fun to play at Combat Patrol at 500 points. Combat Patrol also plays significantly different than a normal game of Warhammer 40K. And so who knows what the matchups will really look like. Today we're going to be playing with the Militarum Tempestus Scions. Josh will be bringing his super elite infantry against my Genestealer cults to see if maybe at 500 points they can do something. I don't know. I keep trying things and they keep sucking. But maybe at 500 points when there's walls in the way and you can't just shoot whatever you want, they could survive long enough to play the game. I have no idea. We're just going to have to wait and see. So let's just jump right into it. Let's take a look at the board, the scenario, and the armies. Let's start by taking a look at the Genestealer cults. This is a patrol detachment or a battalion detachment. Take your pick, because it can actually fit into either of them. For my HQ choices, I've got my general, my warlord, sorry, the Primus. And his warlord trait will be biomorph adaptation, giving him an extra attack and strength. He'll be accompanied by an acolyte icon ward as another HQ choice. In my troop choices, I've got three of them. I got a unit of 7 acolyte hybrids. No special weapons, because I knew I'm up against a bunch of little guys, so you don't want to really bring your rock saws and all that kind of stuff. And then we've got two units of 10 neophyte hybrids. Each of them has 2 flamers. And remember, those have been buffed now to 12-inch range. Woo, woo, woo. And then in my elite slots, I've got a unit of hybrid metamorphs, which I don't normally bring. 4 of them, everyone except the leader, is bringing a hand flamer, and they've all got the metamorph talons. And my last elite slot is going to be a Kellermorph, to which I gave the relic the Liberator auto stub. So normally he has 6 shots that are strength 4, minus 1, 2 damage that can target characters. And every hit does another shot. But the one of them becomes 3 shots, AP minus 2, and can reroll hits and wounds against characters. Or no, reroll wounds against characters. So that one I'll have to roll separate because it has a better AP and works better against characters. I'm going to be playing as the Pauper Princes, which their Hive Cult Creed is, or their Cult Creed, Hive Cult Creed. Their Cult Creed is that when they charge, are charged, or heroically intervene, they can reroll hit rolls. I chose that one. None of the other ones really stood out to me as a winner for this small scale. I've got some concerns with Josh's army, like his one command point stratagem that lets him shoot at guys that show up. And so I have to be very careful with how I do that. So if I'm just going for the show up and charge, I might get disappointed by that. But we'll just have to kind of wait and see. Other than that, there's nothing special. I only have 3 command points to work with because we're playing Combat Patrol.
This is my 500 points of 55th Capic Eagle. So using that other regiment, the reminder for everybody for the Eagles, this is the +1 to hit when you jump out of a transport, which obviously will not be happening, but I also ignore the penalty for moving and shooting heavy weapons. Leading this battalion up front, I've got 2 HQs. They're both Tempestor Primes. The fellow with the binoculars will be my warlord, and he took the Grand Strategist Warlord trait. And the Heirlooms of Conquest relic, he's got the Distraction Charges. Distraction Charges, when resolving an Overwatch attack made by friendly 55th Capic models within 3 of them, if I score at least a hit, the target's slowed down and their charge roll is halved.
So you already have like a stratagem that does something similar to that, right? Like the Tangled Grenades or whatever?
No, the Tangled Grenades is the Custodes.
Oh, that's Custodes, that's right. Okay.
Right. I've got a stratagem, but it's for Valkyries that can slow you down and do stuff. But yeah, not in this list.
So what is the, you mentioned you had a warlord trait, what does that do?
Grand Strategist. So while he's alive, he can reroll a single hit roll, wound roll, or saving throw per battle. In addition, every time I spend a command point on a 5 up, I get a command point back.
So on average, you get one or two more command points throughout the game.
It should work out, because for the other Tempestor Prime, I went ahead and spent a command point to give him a warlord trait, and that's the Master of Command.
Ooh,
to allow
him
to...
You can't roll that 5 plus to get that command point back.
I can't, no.
Oh, so you're already down one.
Yeah, I'll see if it works. The ability for him to hand out two orders is kind of handy, because I did not give him the command rod, because I couldn't if I wanted him part of the kind of deep striking, quote-unquote, forces. Moving over to my troop choices, I've got 5 troop choices. There are 5 squads of Militarum Tempestus Scions. Everybody has 2 hotshot volley guns in the squad, and then 3 squads have plasma pistols on the Tempestors. I also have 1 elite choice, and that's a Commissar with bolt pistol and power sword. And just because I thought it was kind of funny, I brought an Eversaur Assassin for 100 points.
Just 100 points, eh?
It's 100 points.
And the Eversaur is the good close combat one?
He's the bananas close combat one, yeah. That's all he's really good at.
And then he explodes when he dies?
Yes.
Awesome.
And that is my 500 points exactly of 55th Capic Eagles.
Today's mission is Eternal War Combat Patrol Outriders. The deployment map includes 4 objective markers, with player deployment zones in opposite table quarters. 2 objective markers are placed in each of the player deployment zones, with the other 2 placed in no man's land. We should also note that there is a no-go zone in the center of the battlefield. The primary objective is take and hold, which is progressive. At the end of each player's command phase, the player whose turn it is scores 5 victory points for each of the following conditions they satisfy, for a maximum of 15 victory points. They control 1 or more objective markers. They control 2 or more objective markers. They control more objective markers than their opponent controls. This primary objective cannot be scored in the first battle round. The secondary objective in this mission is Survey, which is progressive. It states, score 5 victory points if you control both of the objective markers that are not in either player's deployment zone at the end of your command phase. This secondary objective cannot be scored in the first battle round.
And once you finish watching this battle report, don't forget to go check out the next one in the Mini Wargaming Vault, where Josh and I play a game of Tyranids versus Deathwatch Combat Patrol on the same close quarters map. Go check it out, the link below. Like I said in the introduction, we're using the new WarCry mat, so these actually are double-sided. These are the expansion packs, not the one in the box set of the new WarCry Underground. So between that and the WarCry box set, there's actually 6 different mats that come with that, all double-sided, so you know there's 3 of them. And so these are really cool. They fold up really nicely, but they also fold out really nicely, unlike some other cardboard mats that you can see out there. We've obviously adorned it with some 3-dimensional terrain because there's a lot of these lava areas, and we wanted to show that you are allowed to pass over those, although you're not allowed to put models on the lava, except for maybe these ones, you can straddle them or whatever. And all the black lines are walls, so they cannot be seen through. They cannot be fired through. Even if you had a weapon that would allow that, we're saying nothing can, although neither of us have weapons that ignore line of sight. And they cannot be passed through, with the exception of maybe some models that have fly because thematically they're phasing through walls, like Necron Wraiths, but that's not going to happen here. Other than that, all the other rules are going to apply. We're not going to change how deep striking or holding objectives. So like, for example, here's an objective. If you're 3 inches this way, and somebody, it's the same as being 3 inches this way, even though other games might have you measure the distance around. We're not going to do that. Also, I don't think this will come up in our game too much, but if your base is just slightly bigger than these, like for example, Terminator base can't quite fit through these, we're going to say that they can fit, so you can squeeze through without any penalty, and just keep it as simple as that. So our deployments are going to kind of work out interestingly, because even though there's these fire lanes down all of these, and all of these things obviously are barricades, we're going from quarter to quarter, so we have much different kind of outlook. And we're both able to basically put us up to half our army in reinforcements and come in anywhere on the table more than 9 inches away, but this type of table really changes the thought pattern on how much you want to do that. Before we pick sides and everything, we have picked our secondaries. I chose Attrition because he's got 4 characters, so I'll get 3 points per character that I kill.
Assassinate
is what I mean to say. Engage in all fronts, where I get 2 victory points if I'm in 3 of the table quarters, and 3 points if I'm in 4. And I chose the mission secondary, the survey, to get 5 extra victory points in my command phases if I control the 2 objectives in neither of our deployment zones. Josh, what did you choose?
I went for attrition.
Kill more than I do?
Think of anything better. It's one where I should be able to get a couple points off of it. I also went engage in all fronts because we both have a ton of mobility, so.
Well, and the 4 objectives are one in each table quarter.
Correct. So yeah, I'm gonna.
So you want to go for them anyways.
Exactly. And then I also went for raise the banners high.
Ooh.
It's one of those, I think I can realistically get a couple points at the end of the game with it. I don't think I'm gonna score super high. Like, I'm not looking to max it out though.
So that's where your infantry specifically, which is.
Yeah, everybody.
Does it say except for characters?
I can't remember if characters are allowed to do this one.
One or more infantry. It does not say excluding characters, so even your characters can do it. Can basically perform the action when they're controlling the objective and there's no enemies nearby. And it completes it at the end of your turn. And that objective becomes worth a point whenever you control it in your command phase. But the banner gets kicked down at the start of any phase, not turn, but phase, in which the enemy controls it instead. So it's pretty easy to get on the one that you start next to. It does mean you have to give up some actions, like whenever a unit takes an action, they can't shoot, they can't charge, all that fun stuff. But we've got plenty of infantry squads to run around and do that. Declaring what's going to not be starting on the table, both of us have the ability to start up to half of our units underground, as long as it's points-wise, is no more than 250 points. So I'm gonna start with a squad of neophytes, hybrid metamorphs, and a Keller morph. Underground. The other 4 will be deployed. What about you, good sir?
I'm going to have 2 squads of Scions, the Not Warlord, Tempestor Prime, and the Assassin are going to be infiltrating
less,
in.
And that's less than 250 points?
Actually, I had to double check.
So this is the first time this has ever come up. So I knew that was no more than half the number of units. So you just divide your number of units by 2 and round down. So I had 7 units, so I could do 3. But I didn't know for the points that it was not, I thought it would say the same thing, no more than half your points. But it says it must be less than half.
So you can't do exactly
249 that. Points is your maximum. And it's actually not even less than half of the points that you're allowed to bring. So it's not 250.
It's of your actual list.
Because like mine is 499 points.
Okay. So the solution, do you mind if I not spend the command point to have him be able to order 2 squads? If he's only going to bring 1 squad?
Sure. Because that's what your plan was, right?
Yeah.
So you get to start with your 3 command points. Let's roll off for choosing sides. So I win the roll off. Now this is not to be lazy, but this board is actually symmetrical. And not just this way to that way, but corner to corner as well. Like you can actually rotate this around and it's almost exactly the same. And so this is not just to be lazy, but I'm going to choose this one because it's the side of the table I'm already on. But in this case, the board actually is symmetrical. Like, there's some asymmetry with the barricades, but not enough to really make me think hard about that. Deployment is done. Blip tokens on my side. And then your guys on your side.
Yeah, so we've got basically the Scions all kind of spread out. We've got the Warlord there, and the Commissars hanging out there looking impressive.
Commissars ready to raise the banners high on the back objective. And then...
continue just to kind of hold it, I guess.
Yeah, because you have to keep
it. If you want to show up back there and take it, be my guest.
Yeah, right. Okay, so we're all deployed, and now we roll off to see who goes first. I don't even know if I want to go first.
I don't know if I do.
Well,
okay,
I have
good.
To choose. This is the one roll I don't mind losing, because it's always hard to know the best tactics. No, I'm definitely going first. I'm happy to go first in this one. In my command phase, I gain a command point. All of a sudden, that one that you get per turn feels like a lot. I'm up to 4 command points. Like, so broken. Beginning of my movement phase, I reveal the blip tokens. The way I reveal them, just for those that are not familiar with Genestealer cults, because you probably see less of them now, is that I choose a unit. I place 1 model from the unit within an inch of that blip and in my deployment zone, so I can't like go beyond my deployment zone. And then I place the rest of that unit wholly within 6 inches of that first one, or within 6 inches, I can't remember, because it usually isn't an issue. And that's it. If it was my opponent who was going first, I would wait until the end of his movement phase to do that. So it's nice manipulation, because the squad could be here, or it could actually be all the way back here. And that's a big difference. And so like with these blips, for example, that could be aggressive. But if he went first and he had guys poised right here to come out and start shooting down this thing right there, then when he moved out there, I could be like, okay, screw it. They're gonna appear back here. So it's a really cool manipulation thing. You know, if the rest of the army is better than that could really be the icing on the cake. Having revealed them, we've got a squad of neophytes here. I was able to be more aggressive. I was worried with that squad because he's got 24-inch range with those hotshot last guns, which are 4 shots each. That's 8-shot strength.
The hotshot volley guns.
Hotshot volley guns, sorry. So he could move 6 inches closer, and then actually he could advance, and then he could give them the order to shoot even though they advanced, and all of a sudden toast the squad because 8 shots, strength 4 -2, I'm dead. 3s to hit, 3s to wound, no save, I'm totally dead. But because I'm going first, I was able to be more aggressive. So basically if he went first, they would have popped out here. But they came up here anyways because they're going to be going that way. Then we got my Icon Ward. He's kind of just going to get a throwaway unit. It's pretty cheap HQ. We'll just sit back there and stop you from deep striking in my back lines and hold the objective. And then the Primus and Acolyte. Same thing. They would have been less aggressive had Josh gone first and managed to get guys looking down this aisle. So we're going to advance the Neophytes. 3. And that basically lets me get them into here, which should be safe. Like, if you look, there's no way that Josh can do anything about this. Right, Josh?
Yet.
No, I expect to be able to do something later, obviously. Jeez. We'll roll in advance on the Acolytes. Just a 2. Most important thing is I measured the back guy, and he can get up to here. That's important, because that puts him beyond the wall. So I don't know if that makes me perfectly immune to getting shot at. I'm gonna like look at it afterwards and be like, oh, duh, of course he could shoot at me.
Yeah, here's the lane.
Yeah. You know, but I just, you know, it's hard to kind of wrap your mind around the whole thing. So they're just heading straight towards that objective, obviously not getting there yet. I have no way to double move with this army. And then the Primus will advance. Ooh, that's dangerous. Although, no, technically, as long as he was within 3 inches, you can't shoot him, even though you can't see those guys, because it's not nearest visible. It's just nearest, which is weird in this situation. But once again, we're not going to add a bunch of rules simply because we're playing in close quarters. If Games Workshop decides to come out with a supplement to play 40K Underground, like with Zone Mortalis tiles, then by all means, we'll do that. And that, as they say, is that. That's my turn. So grab 2 objectives in total. No points for that yet. I did engage on all fronts, though. So that's 2 points for engage on all fronts. And the mission secondary survey doesn't come in until next turn anyways, and it won't come in. I have to be holding this objective and that objective over there. But hopefully I'm secure. We'll see.
I think you are.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I never feel secure with Genestealer cults trying to not get shot to death. Let's see what happens. Command phase.
Okay, I get a command point, and that's about it. Start doing some advances. We're going to roll an advance on the squad of Scions back here. Extra 6. Can these guys advance and charge?
Yes, I can advance and charge. If I spend a command point.
Aren't you fancy?
No. It's a command point. Command point on Acolytes from the... What's the name of the book? The Psychic Awakening book that they're in?
Oh, Greater Good.
Greater Good, yes. They've gained that stratagem.
I don't know if I'm going to go quite that far even. Cool. I might just live over here.
Not quite ready to engage yet?
Not quite yet. Other squad here is going to go, and I think I'm just going to kind of tiptoe.
You can take that objective. Go take the objective. No?
So that's the thing, is that taking the objective, it's giving up, it's giving going to give you an extra 5 points to the problem if I don't take the objective.
Oh, because I control 2. Ah, that's it. But you're pretty much... I don't know if you're throwing away the squad, because the Overwatch can be devastating. Do you have an Overwatch to let you hit on 5s?
I don't believe I do.
Famous last words.
Let's go this squad here. There's no reason not to advance, because they're not going to be taking shots. An extra 2, that's fine.
Yeah, you have a leader right behind them anyways to let them move and shoot, or advance and shoot.
Yeah. He will be advancing as well, the Warlord. Enough.
You're within 3 inches. That's all that matters. And your Vanguard squad?
My last Scion squad will...
I call them the Vanguards because they're the ones heading into the No Man's Land. That's the furthest away from you.
Yeah, they're going to advance as well. They're going to get an extra 4. But I think they're just going to... let's see. Because we're going to spread out a bit.
Into the shooting phase. Obviously, we don't have any psychers.
And while he's raising the banner.
Oh, right. Yep. Yeah, you're going to declare at the end of your movement to raise that banner high.
Yeah, it's going to be a pretty cautious first turn.
So any orders that will be of any effect?
I could go move. I don't want to yet. I'm kind of trying to maintain
my fire already base. You could have already been more aggressive in your movement, right?
So. I could have been much more. Yeah, I could have put these guys way up into here already.
Right.
But I didn't want to yet.
So no orders then?
No orders, no nothing. I think that's just going to be my turn.
Okay. In my command phase, I control two objectives, and you only control one. So that gives me 15 points. 5 for controlling one, 5 for controlling two, and 5 for controlling more than my opponent. That's a nice early lead right there. Other than that, the mission-specific one I do not get yet, so 0 points for that one, because I don't control both of the objectives that are not in our deployment zones. In my movement phase, we're going to start by advancing the squad of acolytes. I'm not rerolling that, but that's poo, because I'm going to spend a whole command point to be able to charge after advancing. Well, it'll make it a 6-inch charge instead of a 7-inch charge. But still, I'm not very comfortable with that. Because if I end up having to spend 2 command points to make that charge, one just so I can try and another one to reroll it, I'm going to be sad. Oh, golly. This is hard with all the little corridors. I guess you're there. You know, actually, I'm going to wrap around like this. That's what I want to do. Can I leave a spot for the Primus? I'll advance the Primus. So 2. So he's just going to take up this little spot right here. So he's close to the objective. Although if they run away from him, he's just going to get shot to death. So maybe I don't want to do that. Nah, we're advancing him to here. We're going to be... No! We're already at turn 2. No, we're staying over here. There's no point. Because if they charge into there, he's going to be more than a 6-inch aura away. Oh, when he was deployed, I was supposed to choose something that I get reroll ones against. I don't know. I'm just not... I'll ignore that. Is an aura when he's deployed that I choose one of your units and then everybody within 6 inches get to reroll ones to wound against it. But because I didn't choose and now it's really clear what I'm going for, I'm not going to all of a sudden be like, them.
Oh, yeah, by the way, it was them.
It was them, really. So I'll just forget that one. Neophytes here are going to spread out, but we're going to try to be cautious. Still maintaining our coherency of being within an inch of at least 2 other models. Because there's at least 6 guys. What I'm really trying to do is just shut off any of your deep striking capabilities to make sure you can't come in back here at all, and then push you back as far as it can that way. And the acolyte will sit pretty, zoning out this area. That's his job, apparently, is to wave that flag to the wall and just keep you from coming that way. He's more just look at the vents. I come from below, you come from the vents.
Right.
Right above, because you were dropped in by ship and you're doing that whole Mission Impossible thing. That one movie of Mission Impossible, I don't remember which one.
We can shoot the grates on the way down and then...
No, he waits for the grates to open. Beep! And then he goes right through them.
Is that 2 or 3? It seems more 40k just to shoot them open.
That's true, but that's pretty noisy. But I guess I know that you're there once you're there. So the question is, do I bring in any of my reserves? Now I'm going to remember this game that if I don't do it by turn 4, I'm dead. Automatically give you attrition. I've got a little opening in the back right there. Now the rule is, for your command point stratagem, that you can shoot me when I show up.
With a Scion unit.
With a Scion unit.
That's within 12.
Okay, so if I show up, and he's not a Scion unit.
He's not.
And even if he was, it's not like I'm within 12 of him, so you can choose a unit to shoot at him. That's not how it works. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. I don't know if I want to drop the Kellermorph back there. I definitely don't want to drop within 12 inches of Scions, because you shoot with no penalty, right?
It's minus 1 penalty.
Well, still.
It's on 4s.
Yeah, it's on 4s, and then 3s to wound, no saves. Maybe a 6-up save if I'm lucky. You know, I'm going to be patient. I'm going to wait one more turn. I'll have to show up next turn, obviously. Yeah. And I'm going to remember that, and not just have them die. So let's go to the shooting phase. Done. Charge phase, I'm going to spend a command point on the stratagem that allows the acolytes to advance and then charge. And they're going to declare a charge against this squad of Scions, who cannot see them at all. There's this guy that you might be like, hey, you can see him. There's a wall there. So it's really these 3 that you're looking for, and there's no angle. I need a 6 in order to get there. Thank you, Dice, for not screwing me over right there. That would have been very sad. 9 inches. This obviously gets me nice and tidily right in there. Remember, we're ignoring the lava on these sides because we didn't have the terrain pieces to cover the whole bridge. This is clumsy, but it should still be enough attacks to be quite dangerous. And then I'll make sure, like that. I'm gonna daisy chain it back. I'm still within 2 inches of two, because I'm not gonna be able to get them all in the fight anyway, so I have the 6-inch aura from him of plus one to hit. Do you have any stratagems you can use at this point as we go into the fight phase?
No.
Okay, so nothing to keep you alive.
Nope.
Besides just your regular saves. Then I will fight with these ones first. We'll pile in. And basically, I don't know if I can get this fifth one in here without him moving away. So then I have to make, because that's half an inch of half an inch. Oh, I guess I could have not moved base contact. Stayed half an inch, half an inch. I'll finagle, see what I can get. We'll start with the four rending claws of the four acolytes, because the other one has a bone sword I'm going to want to use. So we have eight attacks, hitting on twos, re-rolling because I'm Pauper Princes and I made a charge move. Yeah, didn't need either of those buffs, but I am not going to complain about that. This is where I could use the re-rolls, but don't have them. Threes to wound. They're AP minus one, but if I roll sixes, they become AP minus four. In other words, you don't get a save. Not bad. I don't like all those ones, but it makes up for it by having two sixes, which will auto-kill you, and the rest are minus one. So three of them will be five up saves. You fail all three, and that kills the squad. Yay, first blood. Consolidation-wise, if you charge me, I get to reroll hit, so I'm not too worried about staying close to his 6-inch aura, because he doesn't make them fearless or anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the consolidation to move towards you, and I'm going to manipulate that to move this guy out of line of sight. So essentially, if you want to be able to shoot them really well with that squad, you don't just get to move here.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm assuming maybe you'll find a spot, and then it'll be fine. But it'll take a bit more work than simply wandering over to the objective and shooting my guys to death. And everybody else will... You know what? You're close to me anyways. So we're gonna hop on the little thing. So we're gonna move this way. But stay within 3 inches of the objective. Make sure I'm within 2 inches. Two. And that is my turn. So the end of my turn, I am in three different quarters without those units also being close to the middle. So I get 2 points for engage on all fronts. I have not killed any characters yet for assassinate. But the score is now 17-0. Now, mind you, Josh has not had a second turn where he can score some objective points.
19-0.
19. Oh, I forgot my... Yeah,
your
the two.
Engaged turn.
Yeah, my engaged turn one. So 19-0 at this point. Command phase. What do we got?
I get a command point and 5 victory points for holding this objective, and then an additional one for the raise the banners.
So 6 points so far.
6 points. I'm going to do this move first, assuming I'm going to basically see where they end up, and if I can end up getting some shots, I'll move there, and if not, they're just going to come around the corner. And
yeah. You're definitely going to have a hard time getting all of the shots on
them. Oh, I'm not going to. I don't think there's any chance of me doing that.
Yeah, but the thing is, though, my guys are only toughness 3, 5 up save, so even just a handful of shots on them can
yeah,
be
see,
devastating.
Yeah, I can't get the angle that I want to. But I'll take that objective. I don't have to drop back there.
Yeah, because I only have one guy on the objectives, and we both have objectives secured.
Correct, yeah.
So you put a second guy and you take it away from me. But you can't raise the banners on it, though.
No.
So you're deciding to take the objective?
I will take the objective, yeah.
Ooh, scary. But I guess you have some guys that can show up and shoot me.
I'm going to declare in advance here.
See what you can do?
Only an extra two.
Garbage.
That's kind of disappointing.
You could spend a reroll and maybe get that command point back on a 5+.
Yeah, I'll command point that.
Yay! So 50%
do I get
more.
It back? Oh, I do.
Hey, there you go. Cool. You're once for
it's
this other
end.
A free plus one to your advance. That ain't bad, right?
Not terrible.
Are you trying to get line of sight of my guys?
I don't think I can.
Okay. So you're changing your mind, you're running this
yep.
way instead?
They're gonna come up to here.
What about the other squad? Off camera, you're not seeing it, but Josh is having a hard time figuring out where he wants to place his guys.
The movement's really weird because it's really planning ahead of time at this point.
Yeah, and you got more guys to drop in.
I'm going to call an advance on them as well.
Okay.
They're going to go an extra one.
Oh, I feel your pain there. I feel your pain there.
Let's bring the boss up then.
The boss man.
You'll be advancing as well, an extra one.
You know what? That's probably all he needed anyways, to be honest.
Yeah.
There's four there and three there. By the way, the nice thing about these mats, although we're using measuring tapes a lot, obviously, is these squares are pretty much 1 inch by 1 inch, not perfectly. So if you're just going straight down the corridor, you don't need a measuring tape. And then dropping in with no fear of an Auspex scanner to shoot at you. Not that I have much to shoot at you with anyways, just auto gun, auto pistols.
Yeah.
In comes the Scion Squad, a little more than 9 inches away, which means they won't be able to rapid fire.
It's more, I'm just checking, like I'm gonna have to push back a little bit with them, but wanting to see where that prevents you from dropping in.
Oh,
which
I see.
Which is a fairly healthy bubble.
Yeah, that's a pretty big bubble.
Well, let's just drop the crazy assassin right there.
Ha! And that'll be a, just so you know, it's a 10-inch charge to make it to me because you have to go around there. But he does roll 3d6 for his charges. Anything else come in from reserve? This is your only turn where you can hold back. Next turn, they gotta come in.
It's the tough thing. Like, I'd love to keep him for something later. I just don't know what. But yeah, he's gonna not drop in yet.
And then you have a squad of Scions as well.
Oh, yeah, there's one.
Oh, no. Those are dead.
I was going to say, like, wait a second.
I don't actually remember if I showed that on camera. So Scions came in right there. I think I did show that, but brain. End of your movement phase. Unfortunately, you can't raise the banners high on that objective because I have a model within 3 inches, even though you control it.
It's true.
Even though you're about to shoot them to death with that squad over there, they will be
shot. I might shoot you to death.
Yeah.
What toughness are you?
3.
Oh, okay.
I know they look big because they're on 32 mil bases. But those are toughness 3, 5 up saves.
I was thinking about strats that were worth popping, and there aren't
any. No, there aren't. Just roll your dice, you'll kill me.
Shooting, let's just...
So 2 hotshot volley guns and 3 hotshot last guns, which are not in rapid fire.
Only 2 hotshot. There's a hotshot pistol in there, technically, on the Sarge.
Oh, okay. Volley guns, hitting on 3s. Oh, okay. All right. Well, you're not going to kill the whole squad with that. And then 3s to wound. Huh.
Truly awful.
What was I worried about?
I don't...
Yeah, you know what? And I'm going to put it on the guy in the back, because he's got cover. Her! 6 up, because you're minus 2. Yep. You have a 5 up save with cover. Aw, no more cover.
Let's try the 2 hotshot las guns.
So there was, I forgot there's 1 pistol in there that's out of range. So.
Correct.
3s to hit, and these are 4s to wound. Well, 1 of those gets through, and I don't get a save. It's 5 up, minus 2. Might as well kill the one that's furthest away from both your squads. And I know I pulled the guy off the objective, but at this point, I already stopped you from raising the banners, so good enough for me. I am greatly surprised and slightly relieved that you only killed 2.
Yeah, that was pretty rough.
Yeah, because they won't run, because I'm leadership 8. So 2 is not enough to make me even worry about it. And 5 are still plenty to do lots of damage to your little squads.
Well.
But, 3d6 inch charge declaring against my neophytes, I'm assuming?
Correct.
I cannot overwatch even if I wanted to, which I probably wouldn't have anyways.
Actually, you know what? Do you mind if I go back and I'll just do some ordering?
Oh, yes, orders. Yep. You want to move?
I'm going to move.
Okay.
So onto the squad here up front.
So they get to move and advance again?
Yes.
It's a new phase, so you do reroll. You roll the advance again. Yeah, you might as well get your movement up there, right?
Yeah.
So we're getting to move 9 inches. Remember, the barricades are difficult terrain. Good to go. And he'll order on the other squad as well, being a senior commander officer thingy.
He can order himself as well, which I think he's just going to order himself to move.
I know that you can.
Yeah.
It just seems hilarious.
Yeah.
It's like, move.
They trained him to do that. So
sir.
Silly to him.
Yeah, exactly. He's like, why can't I do it too? Yeah, let's just get him right behind him where he wants to be. And now a charge, you get 3d6. Not 3d6, keep the best two, just 3d6.
He's 100 points, man.
Sure.
12 inches. Oh, I think he's in.
Ah! That is scary. Well, we'll see how scary. Maybe you'll just whiff your rolls like the other guys. And you are going to charge over here.
Yeah. I think it's an ill-informed decision, but it's better than letting them just kind of run around and continue to kill me.
That is true. Although, you might get some Overwatch or something. But still, no, I'm not going to dissuade you. You do your thing.
If I let them run around, they're just going to murder a squad. So I might as well try, even though it's not a great chance.
Are you 1 attack or 2 attacks base?
He's 2 attacks.
Right, but what about everybody else?
1.
Strength 3. 3's to hit, though, or 4's to
hit? 4's to hit.
Ooh,
but he's 3's to hit, and he's got a chainsword.
Oh, so he's like 3 attacks, yeah. Then. Okay, bring it. Obviously, a major charge. 8 inches there. And I got nothing I can do to stop it.
Coming up and around. Engage!
Just don't get off the objective.
I could do whatever I want, man.
Well, I guess you could kill me and then consolidate onto the objective, right?
Yeah.
I know you can do whatever you want, I'm just...
I know.
Just trying to help out here.
I know.
Friendly game and all. So, fight phase, where do you want to fight first? With your Eversor?
Nope, over here.
That's an Eversor, right?
That's the Eversor.
You sure, you don't want to do him first?
Yeah, I like how you, friendly game. So who you want to fight first?
This guy? Right? I don't have four command points where I can spend two of them to fight back and just kill you before you have a chance to swing at me at all. All right, swing at me.
I don't think I have any strats to help with this.
Why would you? You're scions. You're meant to shoot, shoot, shoot. So with your chainsword and all your stuff, you got seven attacks? Why are you only rolling three?
Because the chainsword hits on threes.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So chainsword.
Oh, good thing. Four is to wound.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I needed that to do a little bit better. Fours. Oh, boys. 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 No!
Okay, one gets through. Five up save. Okay, well, that one could be the thing that makes me fail my morale test, right?
Right.
Right? Do I want to spend two command points to interrupt over here against your Eversor, who's got a toughness of four, and does he's the one that I can only hit him on sixes?
No.
Okay, but still. No. I don't even care what his stats are. Okay. No. Because you saw what strength three, fours to hit guys do. They don't do anything, and that was toughness three, five up saves. This guy's toughness four, what, four up in Vuln?
Four up in Vuln, yeah.
And does he have an armor save?
Or he's got a six up armor save.
Oh. Well, whatever. I'm still not doing it. So go ahead and massacre my neophytes. How many attacks does he have?
Eight. Hitting on twos.
Any rerolls?
No, he rerolls to wound. Ah! He hits with all of them.
Strength?
The strength five.
Oh, so threes.
Reroll to wound.
And what's the AP on these?
Minus one.
All right. Oh boy, that's seven. I get six up saves against this, because it's only minus one AP.
Only minus one, yeah.
It's actually surprising to me. So I save one, so six of them die. Bit of a discussion. This always seems to come up with the Eversor Assassin. He has a rule called Killing Rampage that whenever a model is destroyed and removed as a result of his attacks, he can immediately make an additional attack. Interestingly enough, though, the rules of the game are written as if you're making them one attack at a time. So, for example, the first attack goes through, wounds, I fail the save, I kill this guy. And now he can immediately make another attack with that same weapon against the same unit, but he's not in range to do so. Now, there's already provision in the rules for the rest of his attacks that were already, like the eight attacks that he was making, to be able to hit them even though they're not in range, because it actually says that from those declared attacks. But you could argue, because these are additional attacks that happen after the declaration of them, that they can only work if you're in range. We're not going to play it that way because it feels clunky and feels weird. This whole rule is kind of weird to begin with. And just feels against the spirit of what's going on here. But it does need an FAQ to be clear, because we could really grind down on those rules and debate which one is actually correct. So we're going to play it that he just killed six guys. So go ahead and just roll six more attacks before I decide. I'm going to be pulling from the objective last. So I guess it doesn't really matter. So I got lots of guys in the objective though. So one, two, three. Four. I know I'm losing my flamers, but it doesn't matter because you can pile in 6 inches anyways. So there's my six guys, so you get six more attacks. Hitting on twos, no rerolls, winning on threes, and these have rerolls,
these
right?
These have rerolls, correct.
Reroll. Yeah, most likely I'm dead anyways. I'd have to roll at least a couple six ups here. Well, one survives. Obviously, I will keep it on the objective, and you're going to take your 6-inch pylon onto him?
Yeah. And I'll just go, yeah, there you go. Hello.
So now we're contesting this. Actually, no, I still have that objective.
Because you're upset.
Yes, I'm objective secured. I'll fight back. I'll do this one first because you have nothing else to do. Do I have any negatives to hit you in close combat?
Yeah.
Fours to hit you? No, we're good. And we'll come over here. Obviously, I'll pile in and fight with everybody back. I get to reroll hit rolls thanks to you having charged me. Start with the running claws. Hit it on threes. I'm too far away from the Primus now. But this is where the rerolls come in. Well, five hits. Threes to wound, sixes straight up kill you at AP minus four. So two of them die and three minus one rend.
That might
for
be
AP.
I'm pretty sure that's a squad. Minus one?
One, so five up. Oh, one guy survives. You just want to wait?
No.
Okay. We'll do the bone sword next. Hitting on threes, re-rolling. And this will wound on threes, strength four. And this is minus two, so you get a six up save against that one.
Ready, he'll live.
Okay, but we're not done yet. We've got our cult knives. Just three of them, hitting on threes. And wounding on threes, but no rend for no AP for this one. So two more, four up saves. So you might survive. Maybe.
Might end up using my warlord's reroll here, too.
Nope, okay. Don't need to. You survive with one guy. I will then consolidate. I'm gonna be very careful to, I'm not gonna measure if I get to the objective. I'm just going to, there, that's exactly where I could go. And then I will check to see if I got in range of that objective. Oh, yeah, I did.
Yep.
Healthily, healthfully. I don't know what the right word I'm looking for is. And these are even smaller objectives than they're supposed to be. But hey, they're combat patrol objectives, so that's okay, I guess. That is the end of the fight phase, so we're now into the morale phase. Do you want to do yours first?
I think I have to.
I think so too. It rarely comes up that it matters. In this case, it's not going to change any of my decisions. So
I got to check my leadership here because this will make a difference. What I do.
So apparently, you're only leadership 7. I'm surprised by that.
I am.
I thought you'd be leadership 7 on regular guys, scions. That is. I know Imperial Guard are 7 on their commanders or sergeants. So what are you going to do here?
I'm going to go for fight to the death, 1 command point, and I roll a D3 for morale instead of D6.
Okay. So basically, you can't fail. You've lost 4 guys, your leadership,
yep.
7.
So I'm good. I stick around.
So that's a 1 command point strategy?
That's 1 command point.
And you can do that every leadership phase, rather than the 2 command point one that I will be using in a moment. But first, let's see if I run. I am going to roll it. I'm going to take the risk.
Okay.
I am leadership 8, and I've lost 3 of my guys. So anything but a 6, and I'm good to go. I'm good to go. Over here, I will actually spend 2 command points. And those 2 command points will be the Insane Bravery, or whatever it's called in the main rulebook, that you can only use once per game to auto-pass a morale check. And I could still pass it on a 1, but I really want those extra 5 points. And it feels worth it. How do you feel about that turn, Josh?
Not a fantastic one.
I totally agree with you. Eversor killing a bunch of guys is kind of what he should do.
That's right.
He performed exactly, you know, maybe a little disappointed he didn't kill all 10, but let's face it, 8 attacks, 2s and 3. I don't know. I guess he could have done it. I felt like I rolled a round average on my 6s.
I think you rolled a little high on your 6s.
I think it was slightly above, but it wasn't like
twice as many
6s. I got 3 6s total out of like, let's see, it was 8. It was 14 dice and I got 3 6s. So that was pretty good. Should have got 2 and 2 and a bit. And I got that 3. So I'm happy with that. That allowed me to hold on to that objective, which is very important for what's about to happen. And we're contesting that objective now, which means I'll have more than you, which is a lot of points that I'm about to get. So let's go into Genestealer Cult's turn 2. My command phase, I'll get a command point, I'm back up to 3. I'd really expected playing Combat Patrol not to have command points to work with, but I forgot that you get one every turn, because normally when you start with 12 and you're getting one every turn, that doesn't really make a huge difference, but when you start with 3, it does. I currently control 2 objectives. And Josh currently controls only 1. That one is contested with 2 objective secured units, 1 model from each unit on that objective. And that means I get 15 points. Yikes.
That hurts real bad.
Yeah, but I don't get my mission specific one to survey these 2 objectives, although I might soon, but we'll see. That depends, you still have another guy in reserve. And then other than that, assassinate, I have not killed a character yet. And we forgot to talk about yours actually. You do have Engage on All Fronts.
Oh.
Because you have the Assassin over here.
I don't know if I managed to get the squad far enough away over there.
No. Oh, you wondered for the extra points. But you definitely have these 3. This squad, no. Well, no, you know what?
No, I think I'm too close.
Let's check it, because he's not part of that squad. So it's to this spot right here.
Yeah.
Oh, you're just in.
Yeah,
you're
I couldn't get quite far enough.
Yeah, a little bit further, and you would have actually been able to get 3 points for that instead of just 2. Well, on my movement phase, I'm obviously going to fall back with this neophyte. The question is where? I got to get more than 3 inches away from you so you can't heroically intervene me. Because you can't heroically intervene 6 inches with this guy, is that correct?
I'm double checking and no, I cannot.
Okay.
I realize now my error in not going for the stim overload, just to swing again.
So stim overload is 2 command point stratagem for the assassins.
For the assassin, and I would have just been able to swing another 8 attacks at him.
Yeah, which would have murdered him.
The 50-50 chance I took a mortal wound off it, though.
Oh, no.
But yeah.
Oh, no.
That is a huge mistake.
Yeah, no, okay. So, sorry.
Hashtag not sorry.
Hashtag,
it's
10 more points for me, right? Yeah. Having the second objective and more than you. So that sucks. So I will fall back this way just to stay on the objective, be more than 3 inches away from you. Obviously, I'm going to die, but in the meantime, that's not your objective. You know, actually, I'm going to go this way. Thanks to the placement of these, I can be closer to the objective, 3 inches away from the objective and not 3 inches of you. This is just me trying to zone out a little bit for deep striking for you. And then I realize this wall is stopping me from doing that, so okay, we're just going to hold the objective. We're not going to do double duty here. The wolf, stop me! He like backs up against the wall.
Oh no.
And Sassy just looks across the room at him, like.
Scratching himself with the neural gauntlet.
Yeah. I'm gonna bring the Primus up to this area. Movement phase. Josh.
Do it.
You ready for
it? Do it, I dare you.
You want an assassin fight?
Yeah.
We even kind of look the same. You got that skull looking head?
It's gonna get real awkward when you don't kill me with shooting.
Yeah. But if you come charging after me, that means you leave the guy on the objective.
Sure.
So, you know, boom. Let's see if I can get out of cover of them and still be able to see you. And I can quite easily. So I will appear right here. Yeah, there you are. Oh, that's the wrong one. What's the Western sound with the Western song? That always plays in the duel.
Oh.
I started off and it turned into Phantom of the Opera.
It's something. Wah, wah, wah. Doo-loo-loo-loo.
Wah, wah, wah. Wah, wah, wah. Something like that. I'm close, but not quite there. I can feel it.
That's the.
I got it. Now that I'm doing it, it seems obvious. Like, how could we possibly forget that iconic theme? I wonder which movie did that one first. I'm sure somebody can tell us in the comments. Then also my neophytes will jump in right here. Not ideal for ranges for firing. Technically I'm within 12 inches, but they can't see me to do your one command point fire at me thing anyways.
It's true.
But there's not actually a lot of spots I can drop in. This table's small, and also you're actually pretty spread out. So like I looked right here, and there's a small little area here that could have only fit the Keller Morph, but none of my other squads, because either they're lots of them like this, or they're big fat bases like this. So I think I'm gonna have to be a little defensive and drop this squad in my back line, mainly because there's nowhere else I can go that they won't just get shot up. Like I think I could drop them right here, but then one command point later, and I'm dead. I'm not gonna change my mind, because as I was talking to Josh, I realized I have a stratagem that is two command points called line and wait, where I can place them anywhere on the table more than 3 inches away from your guys.
Oh.
So the hard choice here is, do I take the objective away from you? Or do I put them here and then put four hand flamers into you? I can't charge if I do this stratagem.
Okay.
Because otherwise, that would be OP.
I was going to say, yeah, that's pretty good.
Well, usually it would be bring big squads of acolytes with hand flamers, because hand flamers are only 9-inch range. And so you drop them in 3 inches away, and then you do like 10d6 auto strength 3 hits, which could actually be pretty decent. That's usually 20 strength 3 hits. Wait, is that right? No, it's more than that. It'd be like on average 30 to 40, actually. But if I drop them behind, I guarantee, because you don't have objective secured, neither do I, by the way, I guarantee taking that objective off your hands. You can then come back and just shoot them and kill them. Or I can put them over here, try to kill you and take you off the objective. You know what, let's try that. Let's try to kill you, because if I kill you, I get double whammy, triple whammy. I make these guys safe by not being able to be shot at, take you off the objective, and kill your guy. Triple whammy. But then I realize there's a doorway right here where these guys can just swing around and come in and get me anyways. Oh! I don't know what to do, Josh!
Just put your guys on the board,
man! There's too many guns! Who brought all these guns to 40k game? You know what? I'm going to just take the objective away from you. Because if these guys come back and shoot them, then they're not shooting at the acolytes. So that gives them two targets, but doesn't give them two targets. Hold on. I'm going to do it in such a way that you can't shoot me. I'll line them up on that wall. I don't think I can. Let me come over there.
You have to stay on the board, Matthew.
I'm going to stay on the board. I'm just looking. All right, Josh. So I very carefully place my guys. And you can see me with the two out front. So there's the sergeant with the pistol and the regular guy. But the volley guns can't see me and the other guy can't see me. Do you want to spend a command point and shoot at me?
Three shots, eh?
Yeah. They're all range to shoot and rapid fire. But yes, minus one to hit, isn't it? So it's fours to hit, fours to wound, and then I won't get a... Well, I guess I'll get a save because I'm within 3 inches of the wall.
I'll pop the command point because I got four right now.
We're in a new battle round, so on a 5+, you'll get that command point back. Nope. No. Not yet. So three shots?
The one volley gun, yep.
Well, no volley guns. Oh, all three hit.
Right. Yeah.
Fours to wound. So one.
I'm gonna use my Warlord's once per game reroll on the one.
Okay.
Nope.
No. So one wound. Six up save with the cover. Kills him. That'll be this nearest one right here. Good try. And that's the end of my movement phase. Whew, that was, that hurt my brain. That hurt my brain. So let's go into the shooting phase. Let's start with the most important. The diddle-diddle-do. Do-do-do.
I shall hypermetabolism.
Oh, you get really hungry.
Yes. But it makes me immune to pain.
So that gives you a 4 up to ignore?
Yes.
So that's one command point, which you'll get back on a 5 plus. Nope, nope. Still no. So I've got three guns, two Liberator auto stubs, and then the Relic Liberator auto stub. So these will, I don't have any negatives to hit you, is that correct?
Correct.
So it's twos to hit you, and every hit lets me do another shot. Okay. So unlike the his thing where it's every guy who dies, I just get to roll more attacks, but they don't chain. So twos to hit. So that's those four. I wasn't expecting to have to pick up four more dice. And twos to hit. So those all hit. And then our special gun, which is the difference with this one, is that it rerolls wounds against characters, and it's three shots. It's AP minus two, that part won't matter
okay,
here.
Yeah.
So basically once we roll our wounds, we can do them together. So these hit on twos, one of those misses, so I get two more shots with that one. Oh, of course, the three damage, that's two damage one, but. So these are all strength four, and your toughness four, correct?
Correct.
All right, making sure I'm doing everything right. Fours to wound with the regular ones. We got five of those, and these are fours to wound re-rolling. Re-roll the one. Ooh, so we've got eight total, all two damage.
Okay.
There are different APs, but you got a four up in Vuln, so you're just gonna do that. So 10 damage. How many wounds do you have?
Six.
Ooh, you should survive then. Are you gonna command point re-roll one of those?
Yep.
So hold on, roll a die really quick. On a five plus, you get that command point back. So it does cost you. And now on a four plus, so you do make one more. So eight of them get through. You're very likely to survive this with your four up ignoring. Oh! Six get through! Oh! You have no way to do anything about that, right?
Yeah, that's just dice, man.
Oh! The Kellermorph beats the Eversword. Now he explodes. How far?
Oh, actually.
Is it 6 inches or 3 inches?
I think it was only three.
Because if it's six, you could hit me. And we're going to ignore the walls for the explosions. I know that normally in these kind of games you would make more rules for the walls, but we're keeping it simple.
Oh, sorry, it is six.
What do you have to roll in order to explode?
Four up.
Ooh, and it does how many mortal? Well, it doesn't matter.
D3.
So it kill on a four up, you get to kill me and take me off the objective. Okay, well, at least there's that, right? You got me off the objective.
Yes.
Explodes, and he dies. Well, because now you have a spot to drop in. So, you know, that's something, right? And then he goes, and holsters his guns. Next up, we've got eight auto guns in this unit that will just fire across at your Scion squad. Before you decide if you want to spend your last command point to give them plus one of their saves, I'm going to hit you on fours, wound you on fours, no AP to this.
Yeah, go ahead.
And I'm not trying to talk you out of it.
You know what?
Because if you roll like five threes.
If the dice are, it doesn't matter.
Okay. Just don't want you to all of a sudden be like, oh shoot, plus one save. Like, no. You probably don't need it. Fours to hit. See, average so far. The look on your face.
See, I notice you don't talk about averages when I roll very below average.
Ah, there we are.
Good.
Over here, we've got three pistols into your Scion. It's like he's dead no matter what, okay? But do I just kill him with this? I hit him once. I don't wound him. And then let's see if it gets real dirty. We got two hand flamers that can see and are in range of your Commissar.
Commissar, yes.
Can he spend the command point to get the extra AP?
Or
the extra save?
I'm not gonna bother with it though.
What's he start at, four up?
Five up.
Oh, okay. Well, it's only strength three, right? Two D6 auto hits. Oh, okay, you should be okay. Because you got like four wounds at least.
I don't know.
Fours? Nobody ever shoots
no,
you for Commissar. Three, okay. Four is to wound. Huh, neat. Five of them. Five up saves, you say? No!
Yep.
He would have survived if he did the command point. Oh! Oh! Wow. I know I probably don't need to, but I'll charge the Primus in anyways. He fails. You know, I don't need to. I don't think I'm within 3 inches, but I don't care. Because I should, well, I guess I should check, just in case they somehow... They're not going to whiff, all right? They got +1 to hit right now. So...
Well, we're playing 40K, friendo.
Oh, yeah, you get to choose first. All right, let me double check. You call it. Am I within 3 inches?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, well, the karma's still going.
Boo!
All right. Simmer down. We'll pile in over here to be safer, and we'll fight. 5 attacks for my Primus, because of my Warlord trait, give me +1 attack. This will be with my... I think it makes the most sense with my Bone Sword. My Bone Sword will wound you on 3s. I have basically Bone Sword that's -2 AP, or a weapon that always wounds you on 2s. Let's do the Toxin Injector Claw. Let's just have some fun. 2s to hit. Rerolling, because I charged, and I'm Pauper Princes. And then this will be 2s to wound. -1 AP unless they roll a 6, when it's -4. Well, God, I used that one. -1 AP, 5-up save. Okay.
I'll command point it.
Really? Okay. All right. Is it really important? All right. Oh. Do you get your command point back?
Oh. No.
No, you're out of command points. Was it worth it?
No.
Well, then why'd you do it?
Whatever. He's going to be a hero.
So who's he attacking?
The squad.
Yeah, because you can't kill my Primus with his 3 attacks.
So looking for 3s? Come on, buddy. You got to do better than that. 4s?
Well, okay. 5-up save.
Oh, so depressing.
I'm sorry, Josh. The dice are not working for you this game. I will pile on and murder him. You just want to... Whoa.
You can still roll the dice if you want to.
No, I'm okay. I'm sorry. Are you okay?
I don't know if I'm going to be okay. No.
That's the first time I've ever think you just removed a model.
I think that probably one of.
Yeah.
I'm eager to get to the Death Watch game. Okay.
Yes, our next game is going to be Death Watch versus Tyranids.
Right.
And yeah, that should be interesting.
No, I still want to see how this goes.
Oh, we're not done yet. We're not done yet. Because you can still retake that objective. You can still push through to this one. You have one more guy to drop in as well. The game is definitely not over yet. But it's not looking good for for you.
No.
I will consolidate these 3 inches towards your scions right there.
I don't have enough guys back here.
I know, they're going boogity boo! Shoot at us, not the Metamorphs that are holding the objective. At the end of my turn, I have engaged on all fronts on all 4 quarters. So that's 3 points. And I did not get my mission-specific one. Assassinate, I killed an assassin with assassinate.
Did.
So that's 3 points there too. So 3 points for that. 3 points for engage on all fronts, which brings me up to 40 points exactly to Josh's 8. 40-8. Command phase.
I get a command point.
The end.
Done. Ooh.
So I've killed, just so you know, for the attrition, I've killed 2 units this battle round. The assassin and the rest of that squad.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but you killed one too. Yep. When you explode. So you've got to kill two things.
It's so depressing.
Hey, you know what? At least took me off the objective. If
it
nothing
did.
Else.
It
if
did.
Nothing else.
Okay, so.
You could have rolled less than a
movement,
4.
I'm just going to put him here just to get that out of the way.
Okay, so he's going to. This is at the end of the movement phase.
At the end of the.
Or the reinforcement part, but.
If you want to call that the end of my movement phase.
Oh, I guess you forgot to move. If that's how I'm going to win, right?
We'll still play it out for the viewers.
No, that's fine. And that's your last reinforcement.
Yes.
So come around there and blam. Oh, so you're choosing the squad holding the objective. I guess that makes sense.
Let's have these happy little fellas come back this way.
Happy little scions? These happy little scions are just going to walk over here and shoot the crap out of the neophytes with very calm, reassuring voices.
This stuff here, I'm going to just kind of cry for a while.
It's hard because he's stuck in this corner.
Yeah.
Really hard to get to.
Get out here, coward. I will advance the squad.
Okay.
An extra 6.
That's healthy. Losing 2 over that difficult terrain.
Correct.
Okay. Gets them to that doorway. Not quite to the objective, but pretty darn close.
Boss man, go for a run. An extra 3.
So 7 inches once he crosses over that thing. He can still get right behind the guys. Oh, I guess you could run them, right?
Yep.
Move. You want to do that right now? Because all your guys are done moving.
Yeah, that is. So right over the shooting phase, we're going to move the squad.
Go grab that objective.
Extra 1, it doesn't matter.
You're going that way. Okay.
Yeah, I can
come fight. You can play it safe and come over here, or you can come over here and try to actually. Oh, I guess I got the Kellarmorph that can start to blammo you. I was only thinking about him.
He shall order himself.
Doesn't matter.
We'll do shooting here into here.
So the only one I can't see is the plasma pistol.
Fix that a little bit off camera. That's movie right. Magic. Threes to hit.
Hot shot volley guns.
Coach, come on!
Okay. You know, my last couple games that I played at MiniWarGaming, my dice were really cold, so maybe this is just karma coming back?
I've been rolling bad lately.
Yeah, you too? Okay, well then I guess one of us had to be continuing. Six up save with my cover. just
awesome!
Salt in the wound! What about the regular last guns?
Three. Slightly better.
Yeah, four is to wound though from them. So two more wounds, and I get a six up save against those. Oh my goodness.
What are you doing?
Well, I don't know. I'm sorry, all right?
This is supposed to be friendly game.
I tried, Josh. Maybe you can roast some metamorphs? The ones that are actually holding the objective?
Volley guns.
Okay. Oh my. Well, you know, there's only four of them, and they're only one wound each, toughness three, five up save, so they die just as quickly.
What's the math on that?
I don't know. I'm not going to do it. Two wounds. Okay, so we've got one guy that can get a six up save. All right, so two of them are dead. So we'll say you and you, I suppose. And then you got all your...
The rest of the hot shots.
Threes to hit and fours. This should toast them. I don't get any saves against these. They're dead.
Yeah.
So you've killed two units now in this battle round, so not enough for attrition yet. So in the charge phase, are there any charges you're going to declare?
I think I might as well declare the charge here because it's going to work out better for me math-wise.
Well, I do have command point. I have one command point left, so I
Yeah, but
I
you're
going
to be
overwatch.
Able to shoot me if I don't charge you.
That's true. And I got two flamers in there, so I will overwatch. Yep. If I didn't have the flamers, I don't think I'd overwatch because it's just, you know, so few shots that actually get through. So 2d6 auto hits with my flamers. So average. These are regular flamers, so threes to wound. That's five of them. You get your...
Four up.
Five up. We're within 3 inches of the obstacles. So, you got five up. This wall right here, you're within 3 inches of it.
Why are you taking away my save? I got a four base.
It means three up. I meant three up.
Yeah, you're close to the wall, you get... Yeah, you...
Flamers are really good indoors.
I'm paying more attention here.
Flamers are really good indoors, all right?
Oh, I just lost two. That's
a two, and I got a couple auto guns that can shoot you. And then we got four auto guns that can shoot you. Six is to hit, four is to wound. That's one more with a three up save. You're fine.
Okay.
All right, now charge on in. You made it.
Hooray.
Hooray. Hooray. And yeah, guys can just be behind, whatever. And then they can fight.
Two regular guys on fours.
And threes for your leader, the sergeant.
Okay.
Four is to wound. Five up saves. One dies. Oh, he's already touching, so I can't actually pile it any further. So these two are within half an inch. So that's where I'm going to be basing who can fight. And I can get that many in, and these two not. So we got four, five, six, seven, leader included. So eight attacks, and these will be hitting on fours, re-rolling, because I am the Popper Princes. And Popper Princes re-roll when they are charged. Oh, golly. And four is to wound. No AP, though. Three wounds. Four up saves. Oh!
Just take those off the board for you.
Oh, ow. Okay. That's not enough to make them run. They're leadership eight. Believe it or not, losing one guy just does not scare them. End of your turn. You now control three objectives. Right? That's something. Seriously, actually, it is, now that I'm thinking about that, because I don't have much left to take you off those objectives.
It's going to be a little bit of work for you.
Yeah.
But I needed this to happen earlier. I get the engage on all fronts for 2 points.
Just two?
Just two.
Oh, you don't have that one.
Correct, yeah.
Yes. So 2 points. Assassinate. You haven't killed any of my characters yet. Oh, you don't have assassinate.
Do you care if I just, or care if I just declare that he raised the banner? I forgot to say it, but he didn't do anything else.
That's true, yeah. So okay. You might as well have raised the banner. Because characters can do raise the banner. You won't get any points this turn, but that means...
No.
And that one has been kicked off, so that doesn't have a banner on
Correct.
It anymore.
Correct, it didn't take points for that.
Yeah. Right. So, yeah. 40 to 10 is the current score. Command phase. I currently control one objective, so I get 5 points for that. Right?
You do.
Yes.
But that's it, I think?
Yeah. And I get a command point, so, you know. I will advance these neophytes 4. So that's 10 inches. I'll just bring them up to here and take the... You know what? You can shoot me, so... I'm just gonna come right in your face. Hello, Mr. Tempestus Scion Prime guy. My acolyte icon ward now serves no purpose other than to throw himself at you. So he'll go there, and then my Kellarmorph will advance because there's no targets for him. 3. So he'll move up to here. And then we come to this side of the table where my acolyte hybrids will advance. 5, nice. That's not enough to get past this, so I actually only move as if I rolled like a 2 or a 3. And I'm gonna have to charge over that. Let's make sure then if I'm going to not get the movement, I use that extra movement to sidestep any of your overwatch.
Yep.
Because you do have 1 command point left.
I do.
Primus will just babysit that objective. There's really nothing else for him to do. We have no shooting, so we'll go straight to the charge phase where my acolyte icon ward will declare charge into your scions who cannot overwatch. We make it with a 7, so we'll just squeeze through there and get, you know, I don't know if it really matters how close I get. You're not gonna be able to heroically intervene. I will spend my 1 command point to be able to declare a charge. Not likely gonna make it, but if I do, then it really seals the
deal. Yeah, if you roll high, we can see what it is.
Okay, I make it.
Wow!
Just to seal the deal, right? You wanna heroically intervene?
Yeah.
Oh, I get reroll hit rolls. No, it's only if I heroically intervene. That's fine, you come on in. We'll start with the acolyte icon ward. I know you can't interrupt me, so I'm not worried.
Correct.
So we've got 4 attacks coming from him, hitting on 3s, rerolling because I charged. Oh, I guess an extra one in there. These are just running claws, so strength 4 minus 1. Yeah, so 3s to wound, but 6s are AP minus 4. And we just get 2 through, minus 1. 5 up. So 2 die. Pretty happy with that.
Casualty rate is always highest on the guys carrying regular guns.
I will... Yeah, I'll consolidate. Because you're not likely to kill me, and then that'll stop you from really being able to shoot. Acolytes on this side will then attack your Scion Squad. Start with the Rending Claws, hitting on 3s. Rerolling because I charged. A pretty solid cult creed, I must say. Normally it doesn't come up too much because I get shot to death and don't get to charge. This is nice. And then we're looking at 3s to wound. Same thing with the Rending Claw, so 2 of them are auto dead. And then minus 1 AP on the other one, so 5 up. So 3 of them are dead.
Nope.
So we're almost done. Throw a bone sword at you. 3s to hit, rerolling. And then 3s to wound. These are minus 2 AP, so you get 6 up saves. And that finishes off the squad.
That's them.
And then I will consolidate towards the nearest enemy, which is... it would be them. So I could still use like this guy to consolidate. That's closer to you, technically.
Yeah, and you get your objective.
Grabbing the objective. Chargers are done. You get to choose somebody to fight with. So you got the Commissar to swing his sword.
He's a Tempestus
Prime. They look like Commissars.
Tempestor Prime.
They look so much like Commissars.
Well, I'm using the weird alternate models.
That doesn't help, I guess. Hit me.
Get a chain sword. So we're hitting on 3s. Wounding on 4s.
No AP?
No AP.
5 up. You kill 2. The ones in the back. And then I guess I will... Actually, you probably wanted to touch my guy, right?
Yes.
So I couldn't pile in that guy. So we'll get these in these. So 4 guys get to fight back. Hitting on 4s, no rerolls here. Oh, didn't need it. And I'm assuming he's toughness 3.
He is D3.
So 2 wounds. What does he have, 4 up?
He has a 4 up save.
And he takes 2 wounds. Bringing him down to 2. And you got 3 of them fighting back.
These are gonna hit you on 4s from the regular guys, and then these are gonna hit you on 3s from the prime.
So 3 hits total, 4s to wound, and a 5 up save. I take 2 wounds. I'm also down to 2. And then we've got morale. He lost 2 here, leadership 7. So he could run on a 6. No. At this point, I control 3 out of 4 of the objectives because your objective secured right here. At the end of my turn, I got engaged on all fronts and all 4 table quarters, so that's 3 more points. No assassinate here, haven't killed any more of your characters. And I did not get the mission 1 because I now control these 2, but that has to happen at the end of my command phase. So score is 48 to 10.
Yes. So I think at this point, I don't feel bad about calling it.
Because
no. Mathematically, there's no way for me to win. But normally, that's not my deciding factor for calling games. There's nothing else really interesting to show off.
Yeah. You're going to kill some neophytes and then maybe die.
Right.
You can fall back and shoot my hybrid and
I'll kill him and then the killer morph just kills me back.
Yeah.
So
and that's it. That's all you got left.
Yeah, there's nothing interesting to show off.
I agree.
Unfortunately.
Because I made that charge. If I hadn't made that charge, then you might be able to argue.
There would be a little bit. Because, I mean, like, he can fall back, order himself to still be able to function as if he didn't.
Right.
But that does, it's not going to make a big difference.
Does he have frag grenades?
Yeah.
But maybe, like,
you just throws a grenade at you.
And that kills enough and gets me off the objective if I run away or something. There are some Hail Marys in there, but those are gone.
Right.
Long gone. And my points are way too high for you to ever hope to catch up.
Yeah, I needed to really start getting primary points in the, like, probably around the third turns I needed to start to rack them up, and I got nothing.
Yeah, but I think the part that I can kind of point out as the turning point for me was when you failed to kill those acolytes.
Yep.
And you should have. You had enough firepower to kill them, and you didn't. And then you charged them, and they murdered your guys instead.
Yeah, it was kind of like, the charge wasn't the best choice, but I mean, like, it was my only option at that point. Like, I don't regret doing it.
That may have helped you more than you think, because now that I think about it, I still had the Primus. So the Primus could have come in and charged the unit that charged
yep.
in, and he could have murdered them all. And that would have left them free to charge up into the squad, which did move back, kill the Metamorphs, grab that objective, and then
right.
you only died because they made a ridiculously long charge.
Yep.
And so, and they had access to a stratagem to let them advance and charge. Everything else, except the Kellermorph killing the Assassin.
That was upsetting. That was frustrating.
That was also a big...
Because the game plan was the Assassin was going to move, shoot back, because he got a four-shot bolt pistol
right.
with AP, and then just charge.
And kill the Kellermorph.
And I think that...
It would still keep you off the objective. And if we look at this, the Kellermorph did not continue to go on to do anything else.
No.
But I guess your Assassin would be available.
My argument is that
here.
That would get the Assassin over to start taking care of that objective, and I could have had these guys push this way instead.
That's true. So, yeah, those 2 points, I think, were the big... Obviously, there's a lot of little things that add up to a big deal. But to me, losing the Assassin and that squad kind of melting away and my acolytes not getting shot to death, like, they're still alive. I did not expect that to happen.
Right.
And toasting your Commissar.
Oh, the poor Commissar, yeah.
He shouldn't have... that was...
Well, because, again, like, Commissars aren't bad in combat. He had a power sword. He would have went in and potentially just killed that squad himself. He would have overwatched me like crazy.
Yes, I definitely spent a command point for 4d6 auto-hitting strength 3.
Yeah, that could have been pretty bad.
Yeah.
But yeah, he kills somebody with a bolt pistol and then maybe charges in such a way that he's only going to get hit by one flamer. He could have done some work.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Well, I hope that you enjoyed that. Stick around. We're going to be playing another game, Deathwatch versus Tyranids. It'll be in the Mini Wargaming Vault at the link below. And we'll see if Josh can get some revenge.
Some sweet, sweet revenge.
Yeah. Happy wargaming. Well, I hope that you're able to enjoy that awesome combat patrol battle report of the Genestealer Cults versus the Militarum Tempestus. We got another one for you that Josh and I have filmed. That is Tyranids versus Deathwatch combat patrol inside the same close quarter confines that we saw in the last game. So to check that one out, just click on the link in the description below or just go to miniwargaming.com. If you're not a Vault member though, you'll have to sign up to be a Vault member, but you can get a free 7-day trial and get access to that battle report and thousands of other videos. Vault members are what support us and allow us to do all of this. So thank you very much to all of our Vault members out there. So go check that out. Happy wargaming.